Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot with day 5 of the Skyrim Beast Battle Arena. Today we have the Charis or Chorus, however you want to pronounce it, I'm not here to judge, Hunter against a normal standard, one of the male typical Dragon Priest, one of the toughest enemies in the game. Most of you understandably did go for the Dragon Priest, however some of you realising across history that the underdog tends to pull off a dramatic victory, a lot of you have gone for the Charis, and at the bottom of the screen now you can see the votes, what you guys went for, you guys know what you vote for. So there's only one thing left to do. We're going to have to meet the contestants and, well, see who can pull this off. So, in the red corner, I want to say the red corner, in the red corner, standing about, okay, I don't know how tall he is, but look at him, he dances, he's beautiful, his wings are stunning and purple. He has terrifying, terrifying pincers on his ass region. And his name is Beatrix. Beatrix the Charis Hunter. Looks good, he's in the red corner, he's feeling confident today, look at him. Looks at me, looks at the camera, you know, does a little dance, he's pumping himself up, you know, it's like Rocky. I guess my eye had a tiger on or something, I don't know. But his wings look good. He growls a little bit, he's an angry guy, you know, he's ready for this. Are you ready, Beatrix? That's a yes then. Actually, that was kind of a no, but pretend that was a yes. That's Beatrix, and he's a guy, I'm afraid. Beatrix is somehow a guy. In the blue corner, one of the top favourites for the competition, the Dragon Priest. He doesn't have a name, doesn't need a name, he's basically Lord Voldemort. He just floats there looking awesome, doesn't wear shoes, he's not that classy of a guy, doesn't need to wear shoes. No, don't invite him inside your house, he'll track dirt everywhere. But aside from that, you didn't want him over for dinner, I'm sure he's got some stories to tell. He's kind of terrifying looking, especially when he loses his face like that, but he's clad in armour, he's a Dragon Priest, he's glowing, he's flying. I can see why you guys have him down as your favourite for the competition so far. The guy is very much known in the game as one of the toughest enemies you can fight. The Charis, I'm afraid, Mr. Hunter, may not stand much of a chance today, but we've seen in the past melee characters come through against magic users in battle simply because of the notion of how small the arena is. A lot of you have been asking, yeah, I know you can see the arena, it's not great looking at. A lot of you are asking me to put this arena on the creation kit, or on the scheme workshop at the end of this series, and that's what I'll do on the final episode, on the final battle, the grand final. I'll stick this up on Skyrim Workshop on Nexus and the Steam Workshop, so you guys can download it and do your own little battles. I'll also do a little guide on how exactly to set it up, but really it's nothing. But there's a throne, that's all that matters. Anyways, we have Beatrix against the Dragon Priest, red versus blue. This could be a very short fight, so I do apologise if it is, but I'll be sure to add some slow motion replays and stuff. Let's give it a go, find out who's going to win in 3, 2, 1, and cue the dramatic music. And the Dragon Priest goes straight in and summons. What is the Dragon Priest summoning? It's a Stormatronic. I feel kind of bad for the Hunter right here. The Hunter is holding his own though. He's flying around, skirting around. Not really gone for any attacks yet, but he seems to be facing just in front of the Stormatronic. He goes in, he makes a hit on the Storm, and he destroys the Stormatronic. The Charis Hunter is doing fantastically well considering. And he's just beating on the Dragon Priest now. He's not really doing much. Oh, oh, and he flies away. Ah! Oh. And a bolt of lightning pelts into the ground. I think that could have gone a lot worse for the Charis Hunter. I think Beatrix should be commended for putting up a good fight, for handling a Stormatronic. And Dragon Priest, you know, I wouldn't feel so confident. We've got some tough competitors in this game, and you may struggle against some of them. How do you feel? You're just going to ignore me, aren't you? This is just rude. I'm not a fan of you, Mr. Dragon Priest. Plus there appears to be dust pouring off you, which is just, you're dirtying up my arena. Anyways, the Dragon Priest is victorious. I think we all saw that coming, but the Charis Hunter definitely held up his end of the bargain. You know, the underdog put up a valiant fight and unfortunately couldn't make it today. Tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, I will put the updated score sheet on. I have corrected it this time. The problem was a lot of you thought the lines, where the lines came from was what you meant by, you know, it's wrong. And I was basically in my head just doing it on the colour key. From now on, it should be sorted, 100%. I know what you guys are on about now, it is sorted. That should pop up now, you guys can see what's going on. Next fight, as you can see, is Falmer against an Ice Wraith. Now, on the face of it, that's not a fair fight. An Ice Wraith would walk the floor with a Falmer. So it will be a Falmer Gloom Lurker. That's what it's going to be, a Gloom Lurker. Nobody can cry foul, you all know what it is. Falmer Gloom Lurker against an Ice Wraith tomorrow, in this very arena that you sit right now. Are you excited? You want me to cheer yes right then, but you probably didn't because that would be a little creepy. Thank you guys for joining me. Please do like, comment, subscribe if you are enjoying the series. It really does help, and the more you guys like and comment and particularly subscribe, the more I can keep building this kind of series in the future, the more I can keep putting out this kind of content. Cheers, guys. Thanks for watching. Much love. Bye-bye.